I get emails all the time where people say there's just too much that they're interested in, and honestly, it's a really good problem to have. Subscribers often leave me long lists of all these sectors and projects such as satellites, space travel, renewable energy, robotics, theoretical physics, and plenty more that they want to work on. Some people even know of multiple futuristic technologies that they would love to help make and just can't pinpoint where to start. Let me just say, whether it's 3 fields that look appealing to you or 10, I understand where you're coming from and you're not alone. I honestly had the same issues years ago of liking too many things and not being able to narrow it down. So now, how do you pick just one thing you should study? Well, let's find out. First of all, there's good news. Bachelor's programs are generally broad. You'll not be majoring in the manufacturing process of solar cells. You do chemical engineering or mechanical or physics or whatever, and build a foundation needed to further learn and gain expertise in lots of potential specific areas later on, like, for example, the manufacturing process of solar cells. So trust me when I say, if you at least have an idea for what career you want to get into and pick a major that points you in that direction, you will very likely be able to achieve that career goal or even multiple if there's various sectors you want to get into. I mean, you can list like 10 career goals right now, and it's possible that a single major, or maybe two, will point you in the direction of all of them. It's not a guarantee, but it could be the case. Also, especially in the beginning, a lot of entry-level jobs say requirements, bachelor's degree in, and list like 3 or 4 majors. You need to do some research, of course, and narrow in on your goals, because for example, there's a big difference between civil engineering and electrical engineering. But if, say, you're interested in the structural design of just anything, whether it be a bridge, a building, etc., you might choose civil engineering as a major. But later down the road, you might find you're more interested in aircrafts and spacecrafts. Well, if we do a Google search for, like, entry-level aircraft structural engineer or whatever, after some searching, you'll see on requirements they list several majors, such as aerospace, mechanical, or, hey, civil engineering. If you landed that job and worked for several years, you're now in the aerospace sector. You won't be seen as that much different than a mechanical or aerospace engineer who's been in the same job as you for the same amount of time, because now all of you have the same training. And if you ever did want a big switch, like to spacecraft propulsion, well, that might require going back to school and would be a big transition. But hey, you're working at the company now, the managers know you, and if you express an interest in a career shift, if they like you, it's much more likely that everything will go your way. And I could say similar things about plenty of other majors. The next thing to ask yourself is, do you actually want a career in some certain field, or would you be happy learning it kind of on the side just for fun, or maybe to supplement your career? Like, are you trying to work as a researcher for Google, or do you just want to learn how to program to give you more valuable skills, or maybe for making an app or website? Do you want to make drones for General Atomics, or are you wanting to make small ones at home slash start a business around them? If you legitimately want a career, especially one of those STEM fields, then in a majority of cases, you're just gonna need a degree in a related field, as most of those companies require one. Now, you could, let's say, start with a bachelor's in physics and then go on to do a master's or PhD in math or engineering. You could start in one engineering discipline and then do a master's in a different one, like my friend who started as an electrical engineer and then did a master's in mechanical engineering right after. Or you could start in engineering and then go on to do medical school. You don't need to dive headfirst into the perfect major, but it should all eventually lead you toward your specific end goal. However, if you just want to make some do-it-yourself projects at home, or you want to begin that startup where you need some foundational knowledge, or you just want to learn some quantum physics, then consider getting a minor if you're already in school anyway, or maybe learn this stuff on your own in the most efficient way you can. When it comes to self-teaching, two of the easiest topics I can think of for this audience are math and programming. Now, I'm not saying they're easy to learn like they involve no effort, I'm just saying there are countless resources out there, and all you really need is a computer or a pencil and paper. Compare that to like learning how to weld from home. The preparation would be a little bit different. But there are also cheap ways to learn on your own as well. For example, I work with someone who's in their 30s, works a full-time job, and just finished a 5-month math class on tensors and manifolds. Yes, that's a very advanced class, way beyond what most of us will ever take. But he took it because he has a bachelor's degree in pure mathematics, so he had the background, and he just wanted to learn more. He may get a PhD later, he said, but for now he just wanted to learn. And before that class, he took a machining class, again, just for fun. And this was all done at a community college, so it didn't even cost that much. You see, if you want to learn something on the side, like you want to build quadcopters in your garage, or you want to build something for your startup, there are plenty of ways to do it that don't require a degree or any high level of expertise. So just because you didn't major in this or that that's super related to what you want to do, it doesn't stop you from continuous learning. Now, if you really, really cannot decide on a major, maybe try to avoid the more specialized ones, at least for engineering, which is a large majority of this audience. Examples of those would be like aerospace engineering or biomedical engineering. You want to stay more towards the broad disciplines like chemical, mechanical, or electrical, to name a few. The reason is because if you pick like mechanical engineering and then decide 2 years in that you instead want to do aerospace, the transition to that is super easy because both those majors take like the same classes their first 2 years. This is kind of like the happy medium between not knowing what you want to study and not going in undeclared. Then another positive aspect of all this is you can dive into a variety of sectors and then make a more informed decision later. Again, if you pick mechanical engineering, you can find internships or clubs in robotics, aeronautics, biomedical equipment, petroleum, and so on. Since fields like these are often multidisciplinary, you will begin to see what the electrical engineers, the aerospace engineers, the chemical engineers, and more are working on. You'll be surrounded by other people all with different areas of expertise, and it may start to be more obvious what is right for you. One thing to consider doing is write down as many career goals as you possibly can. Write down 10, 20, or whatever, 30 of the top careers, job positions, or projects you'd like to be a part of. After doing that, narrow it down to, let's say, your top 5. And of those 5, pick your top 3. Those 3 should be your main focus, and you should tailor your education to point you in that direction. The other 2 of the 5, if possible, can be something you do on the side or as a college minor if you have time. You can keep updating this list year after year, but for now, just do what you can. Yes, you will need to pick something, and if you have many interests, that's okay. Pick something that will point you in the direction of those top 3, 2, or 1. Then once you're in a related job position, you'll start to gain expertise in that field, which was a goal of yours. Then if you'd like, you can spend your free time learning about other parts of the company or another sector, or you could do projects at home, and so on. Don't think of it as, oh, there's so many things out there I want to do, how will I ever accomplish it? Just focus on 1 or 2 things at a time. Like dive into some project for a few weeks that's outside of your required classes. Or really focus on your career for a few years and gain those skills, then think about diversifying more as you go if that's what you want. It's very hard to predict how you'll feel in a few years. You should also realize the more time you spend learning a range of topics, the less of an expert you'll become in each. So again, if you treat some of these like a hobby, there's a lot you can do. If you want to discover the next breakthrough in renewable energy, that's where your focus needs to be. I know this video won't help you know whether one major is right or wrong for you, as that's what plenty of the other videos on this channel are for, but I hope it makes it so that when you do make a decision, you're more confident that you're at least heading in the right direction. And I'm gonna end that video there. I'm finally writing the scripts for a new physics major video and an engineering versus physics video, so for anyone who wants more info on that, it's coming very soon. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to like and subscribe. Don't forget to follow me on Twitter and join the Major Prep Facebook group for updates on everything. Major Prep merch can be found below, and I'll see you all in the next video.